football. This show is being brought to you by Daly's Juice Products, who remind you that there's a Daly's treat for everyone. And by Long John Silver's Seafood Shop. For fish, chicken, and a whole lot more, Long John Silver sounds good to me. And by Busch Beer, the beer with a taste as smooth as its name. And by Meyer Siegel & Associates, fine family of food. LaMagna Cheese, the ricotta for all reasons, and Rocca's Gourmet Pasta. Homemade pasta has never been so easy. And by Westinghouse, 130,000 people around the world dedicated to quality and excellence. From Giant Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey, it's the Penn State Nittany Lions versus the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. Hello again, everybody. I'm Stan Saverin. My partner, George Paterno, and I welcome you to Penn State football. George, Penn State returned the majority of their defensive starters in 1985, and I know you felt that this could be a defense that would be a dominating defense like the Penn State defenses of years gone by.
I think today they showed that, Stan. Now, with the return of Russo and Bobby White, it's the first time that first-string defense has played as a unit since the Maryland game. And I thought they played better today defensively than they did against Maryland. They pursued better. They tackled better, and their defensive strategy was better. And I think that and the special teams is what carried the day for them.
Well, the Penn State defense made the big individual play. They also gave ground very grudgingly, and they put on one of the most spectacular goal line stands in recent memory. Penn State, defensively, their kicking game, defeat the Scarlet Knights, and we'll be back to show you how it all happened in just a moment.
They say the best ones are the hard ones. These you don't break. You try to reach an agreement. And when you do, you head for the mountains. Bush. Head for the beer brewed natural as a mountain stream. For a taste as smooth as its name. Bush.
Head for Bush Beer.
Head for the mountain.
I know. How does some seafood sound?
Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me.
Long John Silver's got batter fried shrimp, breaded shrimp, scallops, clams, even oysters.
Sounds like a taste in a place I wanna be. Sounds good. Sounds great. Come on, grab me a plate.
Long John Silver.
Sounds good to me.
Today's game was dictated by defense, defense on both sides. And perhaps it was increasingly important that the team that scored first might hold the upper hand. A great individual play by Duffy Cobbs kept Rutgers off the scoreboard, and therefore Penn State never trailed in this football game. We'll be back to show you the first quarter of action in just a moment.
Make every meal a natural success. Begin with Rocca's Gourmet Pasta, made with durum semolina wheat flour and whole eggs, then frozen for freshness. Rocca's tortellini with cheese or meat filling is deliciously different. Homemade pasta has never been so easy. Then include the tempting taste of LaMagna ricotta cheese. For over 50 years, LaMagna cheese has been bringing out the best in pastas. Made with pure milk and hot-packed for freshness, LaMagna ricotta cheese refreshes salads and enhances desserts. It's the ricotta for all reasons.
You're never too old, you're never too young. There's a Daly's treat for everyone. Fresh fruit flavors as good as can be, loaded with tons of vitamin C. Wherever you are and whatever you're doing, Daly's has a flavor just right for you. And what are you waiting for? Who could deserve it more? Treat yourself to the fun. There's a Daly's treat for everyone.
24 hours after the appearance of Hurricane Gloria in the New York area, turned out to be a beautiful, sunny Saturday afternoon. Penn State's offense didn't have the power of Friday's storm. After taking the opening kickoff, The Lion offense could not pick up a first down. They punted, and Rutgers has the ball. Bob White, who missed last week, starts left defensive end. Tim Johnson, the right defensive end. Drop play to Albert Smith, their best runner. He breaks a tackle, breaks two tackles, and he's out near first down, near the 45-yard line. Duffy Cobbs finally brought him down, but Albert Smith, senior tailback, leading rusher for Rutgers, picks up nearly 10.
This is a lead draw, and this is one of the longest runs from on first down that Rutgers has had all year. Good running by Smith, number 33.
Well, it's an 11-yard gain. Smith came into the game averaging only 2.4 per carry. He only had 77 yards on the season. And right away, Rutgers picks up 11 yards and a first down. Rusty Hochberger, quarterback, into Smith again. He's got running room, gets outside, brought down from behind, but not before he's able to gain 4 yards out to midfield. Trey Bauer made the tackle for Penn State, number 35, the junior, from right around the corner in Paramus, New Jersey.
Once again, nice running by Smith. He started out off tackle, sucked the defensive end in, then turned on the speed and made a 5-yard gain.
Well, Rutgers able to pick up 16 yards on 2 carries on the ground. And again, as a team, they are averaging barely over 2 yards per carry on the ground. Second down and 6. Single setback is the fullback, Curtis Stevens, and this is Stevens with the football. Driving hard into Penn State territory, down to the 45-yard line. He'll be about a half yard shy of the first down. Michael Zordich, the senior co-captain from Youngstown, made the tackle for Penn State. It'll be third down and less than a yard.
Well, that time was they went to a double wing and they pitched to the fullback Stevens, but Bobby White now just coming back from an injury, a little rusty, got hooked by the tight end and enabled Stevens to make a gain out of it.
Stevens, by the way, is Rutgers' leading pass receiver with 9 receptions.
And Stan, they like to throw to their tight end and their backs, whereas Penn State throws to the wide end.
Third down and a foot. Unbalanced line. And picking his way for the first down is Albert Smith down near the Penn State 42-yard line. Rogers Alexander made the tackle. They brought 2 tight ends to the right side. There's Rogers, the senior from Riverdale, Maryland. 2 consecutive first downs for the Scarlet Knights, and first downs have been hard to come by for Rutgers.
Well, they're looking sharp so far, but East Carolina pulled that on Penn State last week, putting 2 tight ends to one side, and it was very successful.
First and 10. And Scott Drake, dangerous receiver, tight end. Smith. Not much doing this time. Penn State penetrates very well and stops Smith for no gain. Mike Russo and Tim Johnson make the tackle for the Nittany Lions, and we have a flag on the play. Play was stopped for no gain, and here is the signal from the official. And it's a hold. Or a face mask. Face mask on Penn State. So that will turn into a gain for Dick Anderson and Rutgers. Anderson, in his second year here on the banks of the old Raritan.
5 yards, defense, first down.
Nope, the play, no game, but the 5 yards of the penalty will make it 1st and 5. Anderson with a record of 7-4-1. Now in his second year at Rutgers. Again, the Scarlet Knights tied Florida 28-all, lost last week to Army 2016. Hochberg, his first pass, and is thrown up and off the hands of Scott Drake, the intended receiver, and almost intercepted. Pretty good call on 1st and 5.
Excellent pass coverage. They were in that double wing, and they faked to the fullback, and they come out on a rollout, and Rogers Alexander and Shane Conlon. It was excellent pass coverage.
Conlon was the man who got the tip on the ball. Incomplete, 2nd down and 5. There you see Dick Anderson, 1965 Penn State graduate. And he served as that man's offensive coordinator for a number of years. Joe Paterno, of course, in his 20th year at Penn State, 3-0 in his 20th year. Smith with a short side pitch. Trey Bauer came across and gave Smith a real hard lick down near the 35, called the 36-yard line. Gain of a couple, and that'll bring up 3rd down and 3.
Stan, to talk a little bit about Smith. Now, he's not a real fast back. He's a power back, and he spins very well. And we have seen that already on about 3 carries. Notice how he spins out of the tackle, and you have to really grab him to put him down. He's a strong run.
Smith is a senior, 6 feet, 210 pounds. As a matter of fact, he is approaching Rutgers' record in terms of rushing.
Third down and three. Rutgers 1-for-1 on third down conversion. Hochberg wants to throw. Out in the flat to Smith. Cuts inside. He's got the first down at the 29-yard line. Alexander and Bauer made the tackle, but Smith, who was trapped short of the first down, made a nice move at the 30 and got the first down.
Well, that's a play. Now watch Hochberg look downfield. They do this very well. He looks downfield and he reads the linebacker. Now, if the linebacker's dropped to stop the curl pattern, he has an outlet man there, Smith. They got an offensive man in front of him to make a block, and they make the first down.
Right, so they start out after their second first down, third first down at the 28-yard line. Again, the eye backfield. Smith finds a crack. Good running by Albert Smith. You saw that there was not much of a hole. He found the crack, managed to pick up three to the 25-yard line. Alexander and Trey Bauer, again, the two inside linebackers, making the tackle for Penn State.
Well, Russo made good penetration, and he forced Smith to come to the inside. Almost had him in the back.
Pretty good drive for Rutgers. It started at their own 35-yard line after Penn State punted on the initial possession of the game. Penn State leads the all-time series 12-1, and Rutgers has not won a game since 1918, the first game of the series. Penn State's won 12 in a row. That's Smith in motion. Fullback Stevens caught at the line of scrimmage and spills forward for a couple down to the 23-yard line. Donnie Graham made the tackle, the junior from Pittsburgh.
Stan, Rutgers is trying to do some of the things that East Carolina did very well against Penn State. East Carolina ran that fullback up the middle many times, most of the time on trap plays, sometimes on just zone blocking. And that's what Rutgers is doing now. They're attacking the middle of Penn State's line with some traps and a little zone block.
Well, Rutgers with a third down conversion. They are 2 out of 2 on third downs. It is 3rd and 5. Hochberg, sideline, and it is intercepted by Penn State. Duffy Cobb stepped in front of the intended receiver, Raffelli, and Duffy Cobb, his first interception of the season, stops the Rutgers drive when they were definitely in field goal position. After Cobb's interception, the offenses of both Penn State and Rutgers could not move against each other's defensive units. Teams kept exchanging punts. The first quarter ended with neither team getting on the scoreboard. We'll be back right after this.
Introducing Best of the Big Bands, a special collector's edition of 42 of your favorite songs from the 30s and 40s by the original artists. You'll get Duke Ellington, Tommy Dorsey, Jimmy Dorsey, Benny Goodman, Count Basie, Vaughn Monroe, Artie Shaw, Harry James, Les Brown, Buddy Rich, Fats Waller, Glenn Miller, and many more. The best of the big bands can be yours for the incredible low price of $19.98 for the records or cassettes. And this fabulous offer is not available in stores, so order yours now.
To get your 42 big band hits, call toll-free 1-800-453-9507. That's 1-800-453-9507. Or save COD charges and send $19.98 plus $3 postage and handling to Big Bands. P.O. Box 1899, Fort Lee, New Jersey.
Once again, the $500,000 Virginia Slims Championships at Madison Square Garden set worldwide attendance records. To ensure prime seating for our next event, March 17th through the 23rd, 1986, it's not too early to order your box or series seats now before the general sale begins. See Martina, Chris, and the rest of the top 16 at the richest and best attended women's tennis tournament in the world. Call 212-563-8954 for more information on the 1986 Virginia Slims Championships.
In 1859, Isaac Cook created a great American champagne to launch the great American clipper ships. Today, Americans are still launching celebrations with Cook's Imperial American Champagne. When your ship comes in, celebrate with Cook's Imperial American Champagne.
We are the nation's first curriculum in industrial engineering.
We are Penn State.
We are the world's first research reactor on a university campus.
We are Penn State.
And And we are a national leader in coal and mining research. Here in a film made under high magnification in Penn State's coal research labs, we're watching coal, under heat, turn into a liquid. The knowledge gained from these studies is computerized and stored in Penn State's Coal Data Bank, the world's most comprehensive collection of facts for coal research. Penn State researchers are leading the search for new and better ways to use coal. If you'd like to know more about Penn State and its special opportunities, write Penn State Information, Department 1000, University Park, Pennsylvania, 16802.
We are Penn State!
The Penn State offense was struggling, but each time the Penn State defense would more than hold up their end. When the Penn State offense finally started to move, they did it lightning quick. The defense did their part as well, with one of the most remembered goal line stands in recent memory. The Nittany Lions starting out just inside Rutgers territory at midfield. Rob Smith remains the center, Shavers the quarterback. First and 10, the straight drop. Waiting for the man to clear. Intercepted. No call on the play. The receiver was knocked down. Brittingham into Penn State territory.
Well,
Kevin Woods knocked him out of bounds, but the tight end, Domitio, was knocked down. He was tackled before the pass got there.
Well,
watch
let's
it.
Let's take a look at this. He tries to drill it. I mean, forced it just a little bit, but he's knocked down. And he was knocked down by the defender. And it doesn't make any difference if it's intentional or not. It's still interference.
Absolutely. Well, John Schaefer throwing his sixth interception of the year.
Watch
look
this.
At that. You see it at the 32-yard line. Can't be any question about that. That's the second time. Now, there's no way that the receiver could have caught the ball. It was thrown too high, nonetheless. So Rutgers evens out the turnovers. Albert Smith, nice hole. Down to the Penn State 45-yard line. That'll be good for 7 yards. Graham makes the tackle for Penn State. Second down and 3. Now that certainly changed the field position around. You have a first down in midfield. Now you're backing up in Rutgers into Penn State territory for the second time. Second down and 3. Hit in the backfield and dropped for a loss. Great penetration by Don Graham, who's been all over the place today. The play loses 2. That'll bring up 3rd down and 6.
Great anticipation by Graham. Came on his own from the corner, from the linebacker, guessing that they were going to go to the weak side, and made a fine defensive play.
In case you're thinking about it, it certainly looks like a field goal game. Tom Angstedt is one of the best kickers in the East for Rutgers. So Penn State needs to hold Rutgers here to keep him out of field goal range. Gagliardi over the middle, short of the first down. Heck of a play by Michael Zordich. They play only gains 2. It'll be 4th down and 4. Great play by Michael Zordich.
Well, they had man-to-man on that. Watch Zordich come here, going right to left. They try to get to the tight end, but he's got a man-to-man, as he is, as a strong safety, and makes a great defensive tackle.
So Campbell, who's playing a lot today because Scott Drake is nursing an injury, makes the reception, and that is Campbell's 7th of the year, but only for 2 yards. And once again, Rutgers will be forced to punt, although they should get the advantage in field position this time. And a good punt. And it will bounce to the 5 and go into the end zone. So good punt by O'Connell. He did all that he possibly could after the touchback. 1st down, 10, Penn State, 20-yard line. Counterplay to David Clark. Gets a hole up the middle, and Clark is loose. He's the 40. Got a blocker ahead of him. Needs one block. Cuts inside, 2 blockers. 20, 10. He's dropped down at the 3-yard line. David Clark.
You know who
77-yard run.
And you know who made the key block for him?
John Schaefer.
John Schaefer got out front. That was a great play.
David Clark, the senior from Deptford, New Jersey.
All right, they got it. It's a little counter trap. All right, now he made the cut. See, you see the flow of the linebacker? He cut against the grain, against the linebacker. He's a strong runner, not the fastest. But look at John Schaefer, number 14, the quarterback, get out in front of the ball carrier.
Steve Smith was the second man to join the blocking convoy. 1st down and goal at the 3-yard line. Kevin Woods comes in along with Tim Manoa. Wing back Steve Smith. Woods, touchdown, he waltzes in. And just like that, Penn State, 80 yards, two plays, touchdown.
Man in motion again. See the lead man in motion. Cut it. Come in and seal off the linebacker. And Woods danced into that hole. Danced into the end zone. Here's another angle. Good offensive surge by the right side. But the key man was Smith, number 33, coming in motion and cracking back on the linebacker.
Massimo Manca, 7 of 7 on extra points. You can make that now 8 out of 8. Following the Penn State touchdown, Rutgers has picked up 3 first downs. Move deep into Lion territory. First and 10, the 14-yard line. The Scarlet Knights with 8 first downs. High backfield with Stevens and Smith. Smith, counterplay, gets outside and is run out of bounds at the 12-yard line. Good pursuit by Don Graham, again playing a strong game today. Michael Zordich cleaned up.
I watch, you see a linebacker plug here. It's Graham, had him in the backfield, and you cannot let him get away like that. Could have been a nice loss for Penn State against Rutgers. Would have been about a 4 or 5 yard loss.
I take back what I said. It was Bauer who got the first in on Zordich, cleaned up. Graham had him a chance. So instead of a 3 yard loss, a 2 yard gain, second down and 8. A lot of time to play. 3:44 in the first half. Gagliardi looking, and it is caught at the 5 yard line. Ray Isom made the tackle, but the gain is down to the 5, where it'll be 3rd down and 1.
Now, this is a great throw. They fake to Smith here, holding the linebackers. Here's your tight end coming across. A standard play down here near the goal line. And boy, he zipped it right in, and Isom makes the hit.
Scott Allen, the 13 tight end, made the reception. Again, the number one man, Scott Drake, has been injured. So Scott Allen made that catch. It is 3rd down and 1, and Penn State goes with their short yardage defense. Rutgers with a power eye. Smith, I think he's got it, but it's going to be close.
That's an old right foot, left foot thing that you hear so much about. But I think he got it.
Cobbs knocked down 2 defenders, though, to allow Bob White to make the tackle. Well, I don't know, George. I would suspect that Rutgers would go for it regardless. Here comes the measurement.
He's got plenty of time, so that's not a problem.
Short. About 3 inches, give or take a centimeter.
Let's take a look at this. This is a nice player from the corner here. You see Rogers Alexander come up from the inside, take on the blocker, forcing the ball carrier to the inside where he's finished off, and Rutgers will go for it.
Olamalu made the initial hit on Smith, lateral pursuit down the line of scrimmage. 4th down and inches, and Rutgers will go. 3 minutes, 15 seconds to play in the half. Same play. Smith is hit at the line of scrimmage. Trey Bauer made the tackle. It'll depend on the spot of the ball. Russo back in the ball game with Ginetti. Smith. He's hit and thrown back for a loss at the 5 yard line. Bob White. What a great play by Bob White. They'll lose a yard.
That's what's known as a big-time defensive play. What they did, they saw the motion coming. Bob White takes it upon himself. You see the motion man going right to left, and he comes in on his own, takes on the lead blocker, and puts the ball carrier down. Just a simply a great defensive play.
He defeated Vernon Williams, the fullback, and Matt Johnson snuck in there and maybe forced Smith to go a little bit wider than he wanted to. I kind of think Rutgers going to have to throw to get this ball in.
I hope Penn State's ready for a rollout and a throw. Here's the pitch.
Pitch, Smith looking, stays on his feet in a pretty good run. He gets down to around the 2 yard line. He was almost stopped at the line of scrimmage. That's just a good run by Albert Smith. They had him gummed up, George. He just kept his feet and kept him moving.
Well, actually, yeah, the ball's on about just about the three, so they still got three tough yards to go.
I think they're going to have to throw. I really do. I'm surprised that Rutgers didn't throw on second down. It is now third down and goal from the three-yard line. The clock running, 1:35 to play in the half. Rutgers with two timeouts remaining.
They have Penn State packed in real tight. Gagliotti just might decide to keep the ball. The spread it out might come with that draw play up the middle. There it is.
Here's a bootleg. Gagliotti in trouble, and he's run out of bounds to the four-yard line. A great defensive play by Rodgers Alexander, who forced him to the sideline, and then Ray Isom came and buried him at the five-yard line.
You have to have a lot of poise. This is the bootleg or the keeper I was talking about, and Rodgers Alexander, a great defensive football player, was not fooled.
What a defensive stand by Penn State.
That's a great defensive stand. That absolutely is a great defensive stand. They spread out the whole defense. Gagliotti comes out on a bootleg, and Alexander was there.
So Rutgers will attempt the field goal. About a 22-yarder, Angstedt, is one out of two on field goals this season. Kick is up, and the kick is good. But it's more than a moral victory for Penn State. Seven shots inside the five-yard line, and Rutgers had to settle for 3 points. There was no further scoring, and the first half ended with the score, Penn State 7, Rutgers 3. Be back right after this.
It's the best in college football every Saturday on MSG Network with the ACC Conference. You'll see squads like Virginia, Wake Forest, Maryland, NC State, North Carolina, Duke, Clemson, and Georgia Tech. The Terrapins of Maryland are one of the top-rated teams in the country, with explosive quarterback Stan Gelbaugh heading an offense that may be the best in the nation. The Yellow Jackets, better known as the Rambling Wreck of Georgia Tech, are coming off their best record in 9 years, and with all their stars returning, they're looking for an encore performance. The Clemson Tigers are a perennial powerhouse, and this year they feature the same potent backfield. Virginia is in an enviable position, coming off their finest showing in recent memory, including their first bowl trip ever. And North Carolina is looking for their sixth bowl trip in 7 seasons. All in all, the ACC Conference is a great reason to kick off your football enjoyment every weekend, right here on MSG Network.
Last year, the New Jersey Devils knocked on the playoff door. This year, they hope to knock it down.
Here's Muller ahead to Pat Verbeek on a breakaway. In front, it's a goal. Tip, block, replays the turn, and that went off the goal stick of Chico Ray.
Doug Carpenter, in his second year behind the Devils bench, guides a team led by All-Star Kirk Muller, veteran goaltender Chico Resch, and captain Mel Bridgman. Follow the New Jersey Devils exclusively on Madison Square Garden Network.
I'm very selective in what I do. I'm very selective with my women. I'm very selective with my television set. My television set is huge. So are my women. Madison Square Garden Network is the network that I watch because the best are on it. And the best part about it is that almost every time I turn Madison Square Garden Network on, I'm on. And it just thrills me to death.
You too will thrill to Roddy, his friends, and his enemies with three action-packed one-hour wrestling spectaculars each week on MSG Network.
Recruiting violations should be everyone's concern, but obviously it is not because it continues. In response to that, university presidents instituted the death penalty, the elimination of football programs for repeated violations. Does the death penalty have enough bite?
Let me answer that question another way, as far as the death penalty, the so-called death penalty that the president's committed. I think that the penalty being there is so tough that nobody's going to ever put themselves in a position where they're in danger of having it applied. And I think that's one of the beauties of the penalty. I think the fact that the old days, the schools were constantly on probation, every 2-3 years were on probation, did it with a cavalier, so what, kind of thing. I don't think anybody's ever going to really test them, because you don't know. And they may impose that penalty. And I would be prone to think that if some of the things that happened under the old rules the flagrant breaking of rules the second time. And that's what they were, flagrant. Not caring about whether you're caught. That attitude prevailed with certain schools. I think the NCAA would be as, what's Clint Beasley would say, come on, make my day. President Reagan said with the other situation. So I think they would do that. I think they need somebody to test them and boom, chop somebody's head off, and then it would all be over. But I don't think anybody's going to test them.
Make every meal a natural success. You'll love the goodness and quality of Odenwald fruits and Nolico vegetables. Odenwald is an orchard of fine fruits, hand-picked and perfectly preserved in their naturally light juices. Nolico vegetables are harvested at the peak of flavor and quick-packed to capture that farm freshness. Include the tempting taste of Lamagna ricotta cheese. Lamagna cheese brings out the best in pastas. Made with pure milk and hot-packed for freshness, Lamagna ricotta cheese refreshes salads and enhances desserts. It's the ricotta for all reasons.
All good horse traders know horses. The best ones know cowboys, too.
He needs a little work, but the price is firm. He's worth it, but I'm a little short. Just pay me half now, and if I don't hear from you, he knows the way home.
Bush. Head for the beer brewed natural as a mountain stream, for a taste as smooth as its name.
Bush. Head for Bush Beer.
Head for the mountains.
A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. And this step aboard Allegheny Commuter can take you thousands of miles. We're your gateway airline with over 100 flights daily at convenient departure times throughout the day. And at Pittsburgh, New York, Washington, or Philadelphia, you can connect with airlines serving Paris to Orlando or any place in between. For business or pleasure, Central Pennsylvania starts its journey with a single step aboard Allegheny Commuter. Step up to Allegheny.
To someone waiting for an organ transplant, life is a race against the clock. That's why Westinghouse and other Pittsburgh corporations volunteer company airplanes to rush donor organs into the hands of some very special doctors.
This is Dr. Thornton.
Doctor, our ETA is in 15 minutes.
It's a race where every minute counts. And we're helping doctors win that race. You can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
Although the offense would not score in the third quarter, they were moving the ball much better, putting a couple first downs together. That gained field position. And when the Penn State offense gained some field position, they turned it over to punter John Bruno, who made sure that Rutgers had none. Smith now just 10 yards and 5 carries. Second down, 10. Schaefer. Open over the middle is Timpson. They going to call the completion? Yes. The pass to Michael Timpson to the Rutgers 47-yard line. Pass was low, but Timpson came up with the reception. And for Timpson, his sixth catch of the year, averaging better than 20 yards per reception.
Good fake. Now watch him. Now while he fires his ball into Timpson, a good catch. But this is the ingredient that really that Penn State needs to get their offense moving.
Well, this is the first time today that Penn State has put two first downs in the same drive. Sickler and Farad and Smith are in the game. Steve Smith. He drives down to the Rutgers 43-yard line. It'll be a gain of 4 to make it 2nd and 6. Hoke and Stowe make the tackle.
Again, you notice how Smith came out towards his right, broke it back over the center to counter the flow, especially of Piquel, the nose guard, who's very, very quick.
Well, I think it's important to note here, George, that the three offensive linemen who were not supposed to play today are in the game. Smith, Farad, and Sickler. Whistles all over. We had some movement. Second down, 11. Double tight end. Schaefer with time. Out in the flat to Smith. Gets a block. Ooh, he's hit hard at the 45-yard line. Only a 3-yard gain. It certainly looked more promising than that. George Piquel and Tyrone Stowe make the tackle. That'll bring up a 3rd down and 8.
This is, again, great defense, but it's a good call for Penn State to kind of loosen up the corners on him. Now, he dumps it off to Smith. Now, watch the way it's contained and forced back to the inside. Smith's looking for some running room, and that's Piquel that knocks it, finishes him off.
Good blocking ahead, but just better defense by Rutgers. 3rd down and 8. Again, the double tight end. Schaefer. Throwing sideline. Hamilton cannot hang on to it. One of the linebackers, Matt Bachman, dropping off in coverage, knocks the ball away. Merrick Hamilton, that'll bring up a fourth down.
They faked a little county here with the two tight ends. Schaefer pump fakes. I thought he was going to run it. Tries to force the ball to Hamilton. It would have been out, he would have been out of bounds anyhow.
Steve Plumlee there on coverage, and Bruno will try to drop it inside the 10.
How about one out of three?
He gets the bounce, and Penn State will down the football near the 3-yard line. Bob Antko down the football, but again, John Bruno with an exceptional punt. In a third quarter somewhat like the first, Bruno punted two more times after the Lions couldn't move, and O'Connell is on for the third time in the quarter to punt for Rutgers. Timpson and Coates stand at their own 30.
Return to the left.
Timpson. He's loose. And he gets down to the Rutgers 40-yard line. I thought Timpson had partially called for a fair catch.
Wow.
But the official did not call it on the play. He had his hand up.
The thing is, you're supposed to wave it, and I think that is a questionable call, but the return, let's take a look.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. I think what the official is saying, he didn't keep the hand up.
Well, I realize,
he allowed him to get away with it.
Well, I realize that. However, that is an attempt to deceive the punt coverage team. You know, the guy may have seen that and slowed up. I must say that they should have enforced the fair catch. Play fake. Schaefer looking deep. End zone incomplete. Overthrown intended for Michael Timpson along the sideline.
John Schaefer, has played well, and he has been throwing the ball well in the previous three games. Enough of the average, enough to which he would have ended up with over 2,000 yards if he could kept his average up. But today he's trying to force the ball deep, and you can't do that. They're not giving him the deep pass.
Schaefer now 5 out of 19. When he came into the game averaging nearly 50% completion, you can hear the booing. The Rutgers fans wanted the illegal fair catch signal. Clark, short side pitch. He gets 4 to the 36. And again, Penn State will need a first down here to have a shot at a field goal as the clock runs under 1 minute to play. Pickell on the tackle. David Clark now has gone over 100 yards. He's picked up 102 yards and 7 carries. Well, of course, 76 of those yards were on 1 carry, setting up the only touchdown of this game. Critical third down for Penn State, 3rd and 6. They are only 3 out of 12 on third down conversions. Woods. No game. It doesn't show much confidence in your passing game when you try a sweep on 3rd and 6.
Well,
Twomley and Hulk make the tackle.
I think if we could see that, Woods, if he would have planted his foot and turned up right away, he might have had a shot at it. You tell young backs, when you need short, you got to get up field. Now watch this. See right there, look at that alley right there, and he tries to take it to the outside. If he cut up inside of Manoa, he would have made that first down.
So the break on the punt return by Timpson will have no effect. And we have reached the end of the third quarter of play. It was a scoreless third quarter. Penn State holding on to that lead. End of the third quarter, Penn State 7 and Rutgers 3. We'll be back right after this.
Make every meal a natural success. Begin with Rocca's Gourmet Pasta. Made with durum, semolina, wheat flour, and whole eggs, then frozen for freshness. Rocca's tortellini with cheese or meat filling is deliciously different. Homemade pasta has never been so easy. Add the goodness and quality of Odenwald fruits and Nolico vegetables. Odenwald is an orchard of fine fruits, hand-picked and perfectly preserved in their naturally light juices. Nolico vegetables are harvested at the peak of flavor and quick-packed to capture that farm freshness.
How do you find the scientists and engineers of tomorrow?
Hey, don't stay up too late, huh? Yeah, okay.
One way is through the annual Westinghouse Science Talent Search. In the past 36 years, Westinghouse has presented nearly $2 million in scholarships to hundreds of high school students. Five have gone on to win the Nobel Prize. But the real triumph comes from every kid who reaches for something undiscovered.
Mom! Dad! Got it.
You can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
Okay, let's juice it up, you guys. Put more fruit on line three. I see you've been into the low-cal juice, chubby. Little heavy on that vitamin C, aren't you, Sonny? Keep those fudge freezer pops coming. You're a real cut-a-parve. Okay, everybody, take a daily break. How about that? There's a daily's treat for everyone.
We think Dad's original and special mixed dry cat foods are terrific, but it means much more to hear it from you. This letter's from a cat owner in Ohio. She says her Max loves his Dad's original so much, he chewed a hole right through the bag. Now, we can't guarantee that kind of enthusiasm from your cat, but we do know one thing. Even the most finicky cats won't turn their noses up at Dad's special mix or Dad's original.
At the end of the third quarter, with Penn State facing a fourth down, John Bruno and the punting unit came onto the field. But during the quarter break between the third and fourth quarters, Joe Paterno changed his mind. Massimo Manca and the field goal unit came onto the field, and Coach Paterno was mighty glad that he brought him on when he did. Set to begin the fourth quarter, and there has been a change in signals. On fourth down and six, Penn State has sent the punting unit out. Now, Massimo Manca will attempt a 53-yard field goal. Matt Kisner to hold. Manca's 5-for-6 on field goal attempts. The kick is up. The kick is long enough, and the kick is good. Massimo Manca, 53-yard field goal. That is his career best. And Penn State now with a 10-3 lead. Following Manca's 53-yard field goal for a 10-3 Penn State lead, the Scarlet Knights have moved to near midfield on their next possession. Second down and four. Prescott. First down, he's out in the open. 40, 35, and down to the Penn State 34-yard line. Ray Isom made the tackle with help from Conlon, but all of a sudden, the Rutgers offense comes to life.
A little counter play. Watch Prescott here. A little stutter step. Gets a good block from 74. Keating almost broke this. Now, this is an excellent play by Isom. Made a sure tackle.
All of a sudden, Rutgers finding some holes in that Penn State defense. First and 10 at the 34. Prescott, more big running room inside the 30 and down to the 29-yard line. Prescott picking up five. Rogers Alexander makes the tackle, and now the first team defensive line, Russo, White, and Johnson back in the game for Penn State.
Apparently, there's a big drop-off between that first and second defensive line, because Rutgers couldn't do anything, and suddenly against the defensive line, they just moved the ball right down the field.
Although that defensive line as a unit has been in there before. We'll check and see if Rutgers is doing anything differently blocking as John Schaefer warms up. Second and five, Gagliardi in trouble. Conlon's got him, and he's down for a big loss at the 40-yard line. Conlon and Donnie Graham sandwich Gagliardi all the way back to the 40-yard line, and a big, big loss to bring up third down and very long yardage.
Stan, great defensive call by Jerry Sandusky, the defensive coordinator. He anticipated the play-action pass, came with the blitz, and you see it's very difficult for those backs to pick up that blitz on the corner after they fake.
Penn State's fourth sack of the afternoon. Make it third. They didn't give one to Lance Hamilton on that one play. It is third down and 15. They have to get to the 24. The ball spotted at the Penn State 39. See if they come again. Straight rush. Gagliardi over the middle. And sliding catch. Is it a fumble or an incompletion? They mark it a catch. It's got to be a fumble. But they're going to rule that he was down, that the ground caused the fumble. Hamilton came up with the fumble. Isom made the tackle. Gagliardi on the roll. He throws. It is caught. No, he dropped it. The ball was in the hands of Hoover, the wide receiver, but a solid hit
Duffy Cobbs over there knocked it loose, and a big defensive play by Duffy Cobbs. After holding Rutgers on fourth and two, the Lion offense moved to the Knights 22. Mankin missed a 39-yard field goal. We pick up fourth quarter action. Matt Kisner replacing the injured John Schaefer at quarterback. Double tight end. Kisner. He's going to run with it. He's got the first down across the 35 and out to the 36.
And that's one thing he does well. He can put it away and run. That was a great play for a guy to just come in off the bench in a crucial situation.
So Kisner picks up 4 yards and a Penn State first down. A Penn State, 10 first downs, but none have been more important than that one. The clock continues to run. Both teams. Penn State with 3 timeouts remaining. Rutgers has used one this half, although the board does not indicate it should. They only have 2 left. Clark hanging on to that football. A little too much dancing there, and Rutgers' defensive pursuit stops him for no gain at the line of scrimmage. Well, Harry Swain made the tackle.
Rutgers is challenging right now. They know they're going to try to run the ball to keep killing the clock. This is when a quarterback tells its offensive line, hey, you guys, we can make a couple of first downs. We got this ball game.
Second down and 10, the clock running. 3:35 to play in this game. Kisner under Keith Radisson. Steve Smith. He's got big running room. He's gone. 40, 30, 20, 10. Touchdown, Penn State. Steve Smith, touchdown. Although trailing 17-3 following Smith's touchdown, Rutgers hasn't quit. We move to action on the Knights' next possession. First and 10, Rutgers, the Penn State 49. Rutgers, pass complete to Allen again. To the Penn State 34, first down and 10. 4 straight completions, Bauer and Zordich. But you're right, plenty of time, 2:12. And Rutgers just doing a great job lining up on the ball. They're not wasting any time at all.
This is their 2-minute drill, obviously.
Over the middle, wide open, Prescott. Prescott out of the 2-yard line. Isom tackled him. But here's Rutgers with a first and goal, 2 minutes to play. Third and goal, 1:21 to play in the game. Fullback, fake, touchdown. The pass complete to Campbell. The play fake to the fullback, Lipset, and the touchdown pass to Campbell.
But Zordich was right there, did not react real well. Watch the little play fake, the bootleg action. Now watch the tight end come across Campbell, and you see Zordich come in. He didn't stay with his man.
Campbell's second touchdown catch of the season. Gagliardi's 4th touchdown pass of the season. And Angstad is in the game. 1:17 to play. So unless this is some sort of a fake, they're going to go for the one now and try to get the ball back. Angstad's kick is good. If Penn State recovers the onside kick, they'll win the game because Rutgers has just 1 timeout left.
As they say, this is it.
Penn State with 9 players lined up within the 10 yards. Here's the onside kick. Does not go 10 yards. And Penn State has the option of taking the ball right at the 45-yard line.
That's just what they're going to do.
And they will do that. And they will hang on to win. Penn State fell on the ball 4 straight times after the Rutgers onside kick went out of bounds. The Scarlet Knights got 1 more play with 4 seconds remaining. However, the Hail Mary pass sailed out of the end zone. Game ended with the score, Penn State 17, Rutgers 10. We'll be back right after this.
Being an all-round cowboy isn't always a case of throwing a perfect loop. Sometimes it's a sack of potatoes. And when you're ready for a second opinion, head for the beer brewed natural as a mountain stream for a taste as smooth as its name.
Well, that was really good. Want some more?
Sure.
Head for Bush Beer.
Head for the mountains.
And now, Pennsylvania Lottery. Dump the balls and mix them clean. Draw the first number.
The real excitement of playing Pennsylvania Lotto is more than just choosing six numbers from 1 to 40. And it's more than just watching the jackpot grow. The really exciting part is watching the live Lotto drawing and knowing you could win.
Draw the sixth number clean.
The Pennsylvania Lottery's Pennsylvania Lotto game. With hundreds, thousands, even millions of dollars in prizes. It could happen to you.
Autumn, my favorite time of the year for two things. Penn State football, and it's here. My copy of Blue White Illustrated. It's my inside track to the Penn State Nittany Lions and each week's football game.
Blue White Illustrated is the weekly source that covers Penn State football better than anyone in the world. The inside plays, the hidden strategy, post-game reports, opponent previews, special features like Where Are They Now? And the last word on incoming recruits. And because Blue White goes to press less than 24 hours after each game, I get the inside scoop while it's still hot. If you're a Penn Stater, you have to subscribe to Blue White. Don't fumble your copy of Blue White Illustrated. Order a year's subscription. 30 issues of Blue White Illustrated for $24.95. Call toll-free 1-800-344-1010. Order now using your MasterCard or Visa and receive four free issues. 1-800-344-1010. Call toll-free 1-800-344-1010.
The offensive and defensive players of the game are brought to you by Anheuser-Busch, makers of Budweiser, Michelob, Busch, and L.A., and by Westinghouse, and by Daly. The defensive player of the game is Trey Bauer. Trey is a junior majoring in liberal arts from Paramus, New Jersey. In a game where the defense was on the field quite a bit, Bauer led all defenders on both teams with 21 tackles, 11 of them unassisted. Bauer was a high school All-American tailback, linebacker, and punter here in New Jersey before coming to Penn State. Lion defense rose to the occasion today when they needed to help out to keep Penn State's record at 4-0. The offensive player of the game is John Bruno. John is a senior majoring in finance from Pittsburgh, PA. A punter, you may ask, is the offensive MVP? Well, there's no doubt that in a game where Penn State had trouble moving the ball, the Lions' undefeated record could have gone by the boards without Bruno's performance. John punted eight times for a 42-yard average and pinned Rutgers inside their own 10 on two important occasions. Congratulations to John Bruno and Trey Bauer, this week's players of the game.